Many times people complain that they have learned programming syntax, but they do not know how to build a logic when it comes to solving real life problems. Based on my 15 years of programming experience, I'm going to share with you 10 tips of logic building or thinking in programming. These tips will allow you to take a real problem and build a solid, efficient logic when you're writing your program. The first one is divide and conquer. Let's say you have this Excel file which has base and width of various triangles. Your job is to find the area of all these triangles. Now, if you want to write this program in Python, what you should do is divide this big problem into a bunch of small problems. So the first thing you will do is you will write a simple function which can find an area of a triangle. Then you test it, and if it works, now you have created a small piece for your bigger project. So you now put that aside. Then you write a second function which will read this file line by line, and it returns a list of objects which has base and width. You know, these are the triangle dimensions. And then you write a third function which will combine the triangle area and read file together, and it will do the end job, which is finding the area of all the triangles. So now essentially what you did is, as a programmer, now you are being a plumber. So you are having these different pieces, nuts and bolts. So you're creating those things and then you're joining them together. So, you know, think of programmers as plumbers, where they join different pieces together in a way that you can create like a pipeline, you know, where the water flows easily or where the data flows easily. And at one end, you give your input. At the other end, you get the output in a desired format. So when you're joining these different pieces together, think about a flowchart. You probably know about flowcharts. So you are creating your logic into small pieces, and then you're building a flowchart to join these pieces together so that your program can give you expected output. There are various benefits of this divide and conquer methodology. First of all, when you get a big project, as a human, you might get overwhelmed. You might think, oh, how am I going to solve these issues? And when you divide this into small subtasks and you focus on only one task at a time, you don't get mental fatigue. Also, when you write, let's say, one single function of finding triangle area, and when it works, it gives you that mental reward. So building small pieces, making them work, getting that mental reward is extremely important. The second tip is writing on a note and also discussing with your friends on a whiteboard. These friends could be your college friends or your colleagues. Whenever I'm working on any program, I always first think about logic using note and pen. So I think about what data structures I'm going to use, what kind of for loops I'm writing, and so on. And I will note it down in a paper. And then once I think that this logic is final enough, I translate that into a working code. You can also discuss with your colleagues on a whiteboard, because when you do idea brainstorming on whiteboard, you might come up with a better logic. If you just do it on your own, you might write a functioning program, but it might not be the most efficient or most performant program. When you discuss with your friends, they throw different ideas. Maybe you want to use one data structure, but your friends might suggest using some different data structures. So writing on note and whiteboarding with colleagues, extremely important. The next tip is making wise use of data structures and algorithms. You cannot become a better programmer if you don't know about data structures and algorithms. They are like, they are everywhere. It doesn't matter which programming language you are using. If you think about list, hash map, trees, they are there in all programming languages. You cannot escape them. And when you know how to use the data structures efficiently, you can write better program. For example, I have this code where I have a bunch of customers and I want to retrieve unique countries from these customer records. Now I can do that using a list data structure and it will work. But is that the most efficient approach? Because in list, you are collecting all these countries, but in the end, you have to write a function to remove duplicates. But if you know about set, then you know that set allows only unique elements. So if you use set here instead, as shown in this program, you will be writing much better code. So see, having a knowledge on set data structure became very useful. So similarly, if you know diverse set of data structures, it's gonna be super useful. I have a complete tutorial playlist on data structures and algorithm in Python. So I would suggest you follow that. Algorithms are crucial as well. You're talking about sorting algorithms. There are so many sorting algorithms, and based on your situation, using one or the other might be better. Sometimes people use hybrid approach of using two sorting algorithms for a given problem. So all this knowledge of data structures and algorithms will allow you to write efficient code. The next one is using Google, Stackoverflow, and platforms like Discord and Slack channel to your advantage. Sometimes, let's say I'm doing a list transformation in Python. From one list, I'm generating the other list. And if I'm a new Python programmer, I might write a for loop. But if you Google it on Stack Overflow, you will find an answer which will be using list comprehension. As a new Python programmer, let's say you did not know about list comprehension, but when you do Google or Stack Overflow, you are finding these new features and better ways of writing your code. Same thing applies with Discord and Slack channels. I have a Discord community where I have different channels for Python, data science, and all that. And people are discussing various ideas, brainstorming it. So when you post your question that, okay, I'm writing this code here, what is the best way to write this logic? Then there will be experts who will give the opinion. And you can learn a lot of useful tips by interacting with these experts, either on Discord, Stack Overflow, or any other programming community. The next one is pair programming. If you're in college, you can do pair programming with your friends in the same class, or if you're in company, you can do pair programming with your colleagues. Many companies have this pair programming sessions. So pair programming is one person is writing code, the other person is watching, and he's giving the ideas. So this is like two people writing code at the same time, and then you make a turn. By doing this, you will be using two brains instead of one in figuring out the logic. This is similar to whiteboarding, but in whiteboarding, you're not writing a code. You're brainstorming idea before writing the code. In pair programming, you're actually writing the code. And trust me, it is extremely useful because when two brains think about logic, they give a critique on each other's ideas, and you can refine the logic and you can make your program better. Next one is starting with simple and then optimizing it later. Many times when we have a difficult problem, we keep on thinking about best solution and we get stuck. We might spend 5 hours just in thinking. That's no good. You should come up with a very primitive solution. Just make it work and then think about optimizing it. Can I use some different data structure? Can I use different for loops or different code block to make this working program more better so that it performs efficiently space-wise, time complexity-wise, and also number of lines of the code is reduced. The next item is learning from others' code. Open source, GitHub, etc. has become very popular nowadays, and you can find the code for most of the Python libraries or even JavaScript libraries online. This is the code written by experts, the best programmers in the world. And when you read their code, you also learn a lot of tips. For example, here's a function for sklearn, logistic multinomial loss. Now, if you want to implement, let's say, multinomial loss function yourself, maybe you can read this code and get some tips on how you can write this function in a better way. By reading other people's code on GitHub, not only you are learning tricks on data structures, but you are learning tricks on how to do program management, how to do automated testing, how to do deployments, or how to set up Jenkins pipeline. You're learning so many valuable skills when you read other people's code, especially open source. And open source contribution is also one of the things you can do. And with that, we can move on to the next tip, which is code reviews. Now, code reviews, there are two aspects. You yourself can read, do code review for others. So if you have a friend in a college or a colleague in a team, offer them that you can do their code review. When you read other people's code, you are learning those amazing tricks which you might not be aware about. I have had recent experiences where, you know, when in Python, when you do a split on a string, I always used to get that output in a list. But then when I was reviewing some other person's code, he was doing that using a tuple. And I learned that, oh, using a tuple is probably a better way. So by doing other people's code review, I learned some trick which made my programming better. The second aspect of code review is you ask other people to review your code and they give their critique and feedback. And of course, they will tell you a lot of tips that you might not be aware about. So be open-minded. When someone is giving a critique on your code, don't take it personally. This is an opportunity for you to improve. Take every single feedback in a positive way and try to learn as much as you can. Next one is competitive programming. People think that competitive programming is only to crack interviews. No. When you are solving those small competitive code, you are building literally small weapons which you can put in your arsenal, and when you're working on a bigger project, you can use those small little weapons. These weapons are small tricks, maybe a way you learned to sort an array in an efficient way, or write a for loop to solve a specific problem. You learn all these small tips or techniques or strategies when you are participating in competitive programming. Right now, there are many websites such as LitCode, Gigs for Gigs. You will just Google competitive coding and you'll find so many websites. If you want to become a better programmer, have a habit of solving, let's say, one competitive programming problem every day or every week. Let's say if you solve one problem every week, still in a year, you will solve 52 problems. In a year or two, you will become so much better. The last and the most important tip is projects. Work on diverse set of projects. Work on projects which requires you to do data munging, let's say if you're in data science field. Work on a project to write a scalable backend Node.js server if you're working on web application or mobile app. If you want to become a better programmer, you have to remember 2P, practice and patience. Working on these projects, you need to have a lot of patience. And when you work on a diverse set of projects, you will cover different areas of computer science and you will build this diverse set of skills. So have a lot of patience. Do not give up. Keep on working. I hope these 10 tips allows you to build a better logic or thinking skills in programming. Please apply those tips and let me know what you find. Also, if you know any other tip which I have failed to cover in this video, please post in a video comment below. I try to respond to as many comments as possible. I have a Discord community where there are so many ideas and brainstorming going on. People answer questions, people post about job posting, there is career guidance channels, there are various channels. So please make sure you join the Discord community. Also subscribe to this channel and share it with your friends. I have videos on different career guidance. For example, I have a video on how you can become expert in Python starting from very beginning. And Python is so easy that anyone can learn it. If you are a mechanical engineer or an MBA, you do not have a background of programming, you can still learn Python and become an expert. Trust me, this is possible. I was going to teach Python in a nearby library as a volunteer event, and I saw an 8-year-old kid doing a Python programming, and he was too good. There was a 70-year-old lady as well. I see so many people across the various age groups and various backgrounds. They learn programming and they can become better. So do not have this bias that, oh, I don't have this background and I cannot learn it. Programming is an amazing thing. Anyone can learn it. And I have videos on how you can start as a beginner and learn programming. I also have a video, by the way, on how you can earn money by doing programming online. So watch those videos. Those videos have some real examples. The people whom I have met and who have earned so much money by learning programming. So please watch it out. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.